Hey guys, how's it going? Chris back here, another video. This time I'm going to do a little top 5 list, and the little top 5 list is going to be about most anticipated games of 2019. Now, I didn't talk about my favorite games of 2018, that's going to be in a future video, but this time this is going to be about future projections of games that I really want to play. So we're going to start off really small here, something that I've been kind of interested in. Didn't hear too much about it. I just seen an E3, I guess, trailer. Pardon me. And I think it was a little bit of gameplay in there too. Then again, E3 can just be like, yeah, this is what we want it to be, but it's not going to be that. So they just showed off like graphics stuff. So my number 5 will be Ghost of Tsushima. And it's like a samurai style game, and I was a big fan of the Way of the Samurai series. And yeah, so I was really interested in that. That's gonna be interesting to say the least. I wonder how that's gonna be. Next up is the weeb in me wants to play Jump Force, and I don't know, some of those games are pretty fun. That's gonna be one of those games I really want to play. I was gonna put Super Robot Wars T in there, so. It might be that too. So let's put number 4 as a tie. Jump Force and Super Robot Wars T. Super Robot Wars T, I'm all jumbled up here, is a tactical RPG with a whole bunch of different robots from anime and such. And that speaks to me. Like, I love robot, giant robots. And there's like Gurren Lagann and, or Gurren Lagann. A bunch of like Gundam, all that kind of stuff. So that looks interesting. Jump Force, it's just, I guess, an arena fighter with, like, all the jump characters, like, Shonen Jump characters, like Naruto, or Naruto. I always get crap from this kid at work. He always says, it's not Naruto, it's Naruto. Okay, I'm sorry. Naruto, Goku, like, people in Dragon Ball, there's, Yu Yu Hakusho, yeah, a whole bunch of stuff. There's also Light from Death Note, so I don't know how that's going to be, but I'm interested. So those are number 4. Yeah, so number 3, I'm going to get into, let's say, I have them all written down here, so I keep looking down, but I don't have them in order, so
there you go.
Number 3, I'm going to say, is Ace Combat 7. And why, do you ask? I don't know either. I was looking at some trailers the other day, and I was never really into Ace Combat. Like, I'm not into jet fighters and all that kind of stuff, but the trailer really grabbed me, and it looked really different than all the other Ace Combats. So I thought maybe that would be an interesting game. So I kept watching it and looking at stuff, the trailers, the new trailer, just everything Ace Combat, and I thought this looks great. It has like this anime style look to it, like a story mode, and it looks pretty sweet. So yeah, that's gonna be one of those things that I want to play next year. After that, these could be, no, I think number 2 would be this. No More Heroes Travis Strikes Again. It's on the Switch, which is going to be really great. It was on the Wii, and that was a really good game, the first one. And I just never finished it. I got scared because everybody was like, the last boss was like the hardest boss you'll ever fight, ever. And I'm like, okay, I am not doing that. So I let it go, and I stopped playing. So I think I got to buy it again and get into it. But Suda51 is a great game director. I love Shadows of the Damned and Lollipop Chainsaw are great games. And if this is like anything like that, those games, I'm gonna be into it 100%. So No More Heroes, the sequel, is on top of my list, and well, close to the top of this. Nothing comes close to the next one. And if you know me, if you follow me on Instagram or on Twitter, Facebook, whatever, you know I cannot shut up about this. And it is Devil May Cry 5. Now, Devil May Cry is one of my favorite franchises in gaming. It's actually one of the first games the wife and I, Erin, she's not here right now, she's at work. So it was one of the first games we played together as a couple because I liked it, she liked it, and we're like, hey, why don't we just play this game together? So every subsequent one, we played 1, 2, 3, 4, we even played DMC, and we love them all. DMC gets a bad rap for the poster child, I guess, the new Dante. He looks kind of crappy, and I know it's one of those things that just you can't get over his attitude. And but deep down, it's still a Devil May Cry game. It's hack and slash. The music's there. Just the attitude of Dante and Virgil for that are just not them. So yeah, for Devil May Cry 5 though, I'm annoying everybody, I think, on my social media, because that's all I'm talking about lately, and I'm just really into it. Like, it's crazy. I think about it all the time on Spotify. I've listened to the new song Devil Trigger about, I'm gonna say, 30 times. I watched the trailer about 20 times. When they were at the Game Awards, everyone's like, "Oh, that's such a cringy thing that they're doing on stage," and I'm like, I was rocking out to it. I was like, yes! Like, 20-year-old me was like, come on! This is awesome! So I'm super stoked for it. Yeah, that's one of those things that I really want to play. And it's weird too, because like the actors, the facial actors, I guess, or the scans, they look so real, almost uncanny valley style, but I like it. Like, they look so real. And yeah, it's just so good. The music, John Young Bosch is Nero again. Oh man, and Nero is one of my favorite characters. But I'm so into it. Like, somewhere in this room, I think it's actually in my closet, I have a life-size replica of the Red Queen, the sword from Nero's sword from Devil May Cry 4, and I love that thing. But yeah, so sorry for talking your ears off. This is the top five most anticipated games of 2019. I hope you guys enjoyed. Sorry for talking your ear off about Devil May Cry, but it's so good. I cannot wait. I'm really excited. I want to know your guys' top five, or even if you have top two, three, top 100 games of next year. I would like to know. Talk about it in the comments. I love reading your comments. Thanks for watching, guys. Yes.